There is no doubt that the birth of a baby in a group of chimpanzees is an exciting event. Curious females try to get a close look at the newborn, although mothers usually protect it. Mothers are usually the baby's first play partner, but as the baby matures, play with other group members increases. A baby is a natural addition to a group and makes them more of a family. But we made a decision at Save the Chimps to not allow babies to be born in the groups. We believe the sanctuary resources should be used to support the chimpanzees in its care and to rescue others in need, not to produce another 50-year commitment. As nice as captivity is at Save the Chimps, it is still captivity. That is why all of the males have had vasectomies, but sometimes vasectomies grow back. On July 12, 2007, Mel was born. Her mother, Megan, was 8 years old, nearly a baby herself, and had no interest in Mel, refusing to even touch her. That meant we had to care for Mel. She required 24-hour care and a bottle every 2 hours. How could we raise Mel and make sure that we could eventually get her back in a group with other chimps? This is the story of Mel's amazing journey. We did not want Mel growing up human, so when we were at the building for cleaning and serving meals, Mel was with us. At first this was easy. Mel was content to stay in her baby carrier and look around or nap. But as she grew older, she had ideas of her own. She made her visits to the buildings increasingly difficult. Soon she began eating food and only required a bottle every 8 hours. As she grew more independent, we started thinking about who her adoptive parents might be. She had met all of the chimpanzees at the sanctuary, but was most smitten with Ron and April, and they felt the same way. Now it was time to let them get to know each other. The introduction process was slow. First, Mel had to start interacting with Ron and April through the mesh that separated them. This was as scary as it sounds. These two big chimps could seriously hurt little Mel, but both of them were gentle, even grooming her with their huge fingers. The next step was to let her meet each one face to face. This was even scarier. But again, these two could not have been sweeter or more patient with the baby. Now it was time to open the doors to the island. Mel stepped out straight away and April carried her out to the island. Mel drinks 3 or 4 bottles of milk a day, and we see her when we are out at the building serving meals and cleaning. But these days, our clingy little princess regards us as pretty much nothing more than a food delivery system. And that is the story of Mel's amazing journey. No!